Here's some wheels later, but now, much like this ball, the Tina's coming out is out of hand!
Where's the last place you got lost?
In the banana place where bananas grow.
A banana grove.
Yeah, thank you. That's the word.
I have a banana grove.
I thought you were going to say in a banana. So delicious. I got lost.
Okay, thank you.
Perfect, thank you.
It could be either one.
Yeah.
I don't want to wear this uniform to work anymore.
I know. And it's because I wear it better. You go.
That's not what I was going to say.
Okay, me neither.
Wait, but that makes me feel like you don't...
No, I think you...
You don't think that I look good.
I think you look so hot. I think you look just like... you look amazing. Girl,
I feel like I saw a lot of fruits and veggies in this. Like, people want to talk to you. I'm approachable.
You do, and you stand right by the produce section, which isn't really a job at the grocery store.
Excuse me, would you? Can I help you? Which way to the carrots?
Oh my gosh, okay, so we're going to take a left over there. Okay. We're going to take a wrong way. Left over there. Left over there by the asparagus, but then, okay, you're going to want to take the next right, okay? But it's not the next right, it's the right after that.
Okay, all right.
But the bathroom. I got him. He's fine. He's good. No, it's not. Okay, so first off, I think it's partly like how you stand. Because...
What's wrong with how I stand?
Well, you often stand like this when they're trying to approach you. Like, you're not going to let them have the produce. So you see how that could be kind of, like, off-putting for people.
I mean, I've seen people sneeze on produce. I'm trying to protect, you know what I mean, the fruit.
Right, and so then when they come up and you go, don't sneeze! Like, that's also hard, makes it not... They don't want to talk to you necessarily. Because you're
screaming.
I feel
like I'm just making it clear that we're trying to be sanitary.
And that, you know what? Yes. Yes, you are, and I'm, yes, you are. And you're right, Allison, you're right. Girl, I think maybe,
have you washed your hands today?
What are you, what you were trying to get?
Just about that.
This is the problem. Allison?
Thank you so much. Can I have you,
sorry,
find something else?
Sorry.
Well, she was very grabby.
I know. So. Allison, I don't want to... I was promoted to manager, and I haven't wanted to do this. I have not wanted to be doing this. Because, you know, you're good, you know, you're cool, I love you, you know, you're great, we're friends. I am going to need to let you go.
Oh my gosh, I've been wanting to go on a break for the last 45 minutes. I will go right now. I'll come back. We'll finish this.
Why don't you do the first half of that?
Your outfit change.
Okay. Are you? I can't tell if you're.
Unless
you want
to be the manager too, because then we can be twinning.
You're fired.
Okay, you sound upset right now.
Get your report with you first, huh?
It's gonna be hard to live up to that one.
Well, Janine, you're such an overachiever, aren't you?
You forgot your trophy at the last meeting.
Thank you.
Sorry. Thanks. I wanted you to have it.
You got a trophy from the meeting?
Best attendee they've ever seen.
Look, she left the door open and everything, too. What?
I can be second. It's still going to stand out. I just...
All right. Okay, boss man coming through. These are my reports I need.
Yes. Sorry.
All right, I'm picking up this one first at random, and this looks like it is from Mark. And then Janine, was yours?
Right underneath.
right here. Okay. And then I'm just going to go ahead and put marks right back down, and I'll get to that later. Check out your knees.
Fucking right. Do you ever get tired of winning?
No.
Must be nice.
Yeah. Hey, I have some other trophies in here that I don't have room for right now. Can I put them in your backpack and then I'll just get them back from you another day when I have some more room in my backpack?
You're out of room in your backpack? What the hell? Oh, Jesus!
I mean, we should have just, I mean, people aren't going to like that we pick up the grapes from the ground, but.
I know.
We could have.
I know, but you remember that video from like 20 years ago with the grape stomp lady? And then she was like, Luna!
Yeah, I she got really hurt. It was like,
it was so funny.
In retrospect, we were like, oh no. But it was really funny at the time.
I was trying to kind of do one of those, but I forgot to film it. And also, they were just in a pile, and I stomped on them.
Yeah, I don't think that's gonna get very viral. Just like a couple of grapes, I really do something bigger.
But bigger than the couple grapes?
Yeah, of course.
Oh my god. I thought when I came to your grape farm to pick the grapes, I thought you'd be mad at me, but no, you're gonna help me get viral. Become a viral TikTok sensation.
I mean, we have some like chickens. And they have eggs.
You have chickens on this grape farm?
Yeah! I mean, they're great. They like eat all the bugs and stuff.
This is the coolest place ever.
I know. So
you want me to stomp on the eggs, or you want me to feed the grapes to the chickens? Or?
Is there something you can do that doesn't ruin the eggs?
No, I think you have literally every idea in my head. I thought them through, and I was like, yeah, they're all real egg ruiners, if you know what I mean.
Nobody wants to come to the grape vineyard egg farm, so.
I do?
But we need the kids to come here. They're our blood for money. The lifeblood of our.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely. I understand. Well, maybe we could hire new people that aren't like.
But this is a family business.
Right. And your family, and I say this as your niece, your family's not good at running this business.
Hi, can I have the trophies back?
Oh, yeah, it's no problem. Dude, these are heavy.
Why do you think I'm jacked?
He's always wondering.
Hey, also, Daryl told me to tell you that you're fired.
What?
Hey.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
You look sad.
I am sad. You look sad too.
Yeah. Are you unemployed?
Yeah. Are you unemployed?
Yeah. Yeah, I just found out.
I found out a little while ago too, and this is the street corner I usually come to when I'm sad, by the 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
So that I can.
Dude, it's one of the only 7-Elevens left that they actually have blueberry Faygo.
I know. That's what I get.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, I feel like nobody out here drinks that. You know, it feels like it's like a Michigan thing only.
Right?
Yeah.
That's so weird. Well,
you want to get one?
Yeah, we could like drink one together.
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
You guys sad?
Yeah. Yeah, this is our corner.
Oh, yeah, I come to this one too.
It's a good one.
I came from the grape chicken farm over there.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, yeah. They we're gonna go out of business, I think.
Did you get fired too?
I should be fired probably, but no, I didn't. And that's like a public problem.
Okay, yeah, you're a different kind of sad. So
it's not like self-hating sad, you know? Mm. Kind of like I'm fine, I come from family money actually. Like, I'm honestly a good straight. So
way
yeah.
Different sad.
Don't even really need the job. He's really honest with you.
But I was sad for my aunt, because this is like, you know, this is her dream. And she has plenty of money, because again, like, we come from money. She has like so much money. But she wants this farm to work, and I'm not a good worker. And I guess I just, like, don't know what to do. I guess if I had, like, two people out of work that could, like, go work at the Great Chicken Farm, that would be ideal, but I guess I don't know where to find those people, you know?
Hang out right there by the sad corner for a moment.
Okay.
For a moment, if you could. If
okay.
You could. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Is this a new type of con that happens in town?
Oh, you're
like,
right.
Do you think she's hustling us, or is this real?
It feels a little scammy.
It does feel a little
it
scammy,
a little
like
scammy.
It's too good to be true.
Right.
I just got fired, like,
I just
80
got fired.
Seconds ago.
Right.
Yeah.
And she already is, like, talking about how much money she has, and she's about to literally, like, throw it in
this is very Nigerian princey, right?
1,000%.
Okay.
1,000%.
Okay.
If she asks for a wire transfer,
we're out.
Then we can.
Okay.
But if she doesn't,
this could be legit.
This could be totally legitimate. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
So we'll pause the blueberry fago for now.
For now.
And let's see what's up with this.
Okay.
Yep.
Still.
I want to pick my nose.
We happen to be
fun employed.
Oh shit! I was looking for people that were unemployed. That sucks.
No,
she's just being.
I was
funny.
Just being.
It's we're unemployed.
Yeah, we're unemployed, but we're also fun.
We're fun.
Oh. I use that different. I use fun employee because I am employed, but also I don't need to be, and I have a lot of fun. Yeah.
Well, if you're looking for a couple of people who can help you out, what's
yeah.
your name?
Mark.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
John.
Hey, John.
Hi.
You didn't ask, but my name's John. That's fine. That's okay.
Is there like a job posting or an application or anything that substantiates the fact that you're not a Nigerian prince?
Are you asking to see my birth certificate?
No, we just want this job.
There's an aunt. There's a woman in her 50s. There's a woman in her 50s that can give you a job. Would that help? I don't think she's Nigerian.
Is she a princess?
I mean, I think she's a princess because I look my aunt. But no, we come from oil money. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Like, new money. We'll do it.
Okay.
New money.
Yeah, sure. We'd love.
We'll take a job.
Good job.
Yeah, we'll try it out.
We
oh my god. Okay. I need you guys to come right now and meet my aunt.
Okay.
Did you guys follow me as a stranger and come meet my aunt? Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Auntie? I'm gonna take the chicken from you.
Mrs. Clucky loves to be held.
Well, okay. I mean, we don't have to, but
did you run so fast?
Yeah, you guys are out of shape. Are you doing office jobs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
In a grocery store.
Okay. Okay, so these are Marcus and
just,
Olivia.
Just Mark Allison.
Okay,
Mark.
And I was very close.
Yeah, we can get you on the payroll right away. I mean, I just need you to send me a couple $100 so I have your banking info.
Why?
You know, so I have your. This is how old money. This is the way
this
we
is,
do
this
it.
This is oil money stuff.
Oh.
You know what, Auntie? They were worried you were Nigerian. So maybe for now, why don't we just give them the cash?
I'm Norwegian.
That's what it was. I knew that sounded convincing. Norwegian.
Nice.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
But how about we just give them, like,
the money in cash? You got like $100,000 in cash laying around here, right?
Oh yeah, right under the chicken.
Okay, cool. Okay. If I give you guys each like $200,000 in cash, can you come work here?
Yep.
Yep.
Yep. Totally. We'll do it.
We
can do it.
Ready? You guys sure?
Yep.
Yes. Okay.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Uncle Jeb?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Sorry, I was just so lost in this banana.
I didn't want to scare you.
So you thought I'd creep up on you.
Can I pull the chair? Is that okay?
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. This business is crazy. Okay, I've been looking at their books for the last 3 months now, and if I were the IRS, I would think this was a pyramid scheme, but this is a legitimate business that's just run really horribly.
Yeah. Well, isn't that most pyramid schemes?
They're businesses that are run horribly?
Yeah. Aren't pyramid schemes businesses that are run horribly?
Yeah, okay, yeah, you're right.
Right? What am I thinking of?
Yeah, you're right. You're right. I don't know what I was thinking of. What's up, Allison?
I think we need to put ourselves at the top of this pyramid. You know what I mean? It's clear that they don't know what they're doing. We can probably find a way to, like, push this ant out. And then we can run the show.
Are you suggesting we murder the ant?
No! Why is that your first assumption?
Just, I'm sorry, okay? I see something and I get scared. That, you know, I just think of worst case scenario.
No.
You know,
no.
I always freak out.
No, all I'm saying is that she's getting older, okay? And it wouldn't be weird if she, you know, wanted to retire. And we could push her towards retirement, you know? And get her to write us into her will.
You see, now it definitely seems like you want her to die.
No. I'm just saying. It would be, like, you know, easier.
Why do you want to run this business so bad?
Because they've got cash laying around everywhere, and they don't know what to do with it. They're stomping eggs in the back instead of selling them, which could be even more money. We could run this, you and me, together.
Have you guys seen the $600 laying around anywhere here?
Hey, Jen. No.
Did you check your pocket?
Oh. Don't.
Yeah, I do.
Alright.
I think we can run this race.
Yeah, so then let's do it. She's talking about how she's tired all the time. You know? We should talk to her and see if, maybe she'll just give it to us. Maybe she'll be like, you know, fuck this, I'm out.
Okay, let's talk to her.
Let's just talk to her.
It's just a conversation. What can happen?
Nothing could happen. Nothing bad could happen.
I'll kill you both! I will kill both of you! You want to write me out of the will?
Whoa, nobody said that, okay? We just wanted to be written in.
I'm trying to be so chill right now, Amy. I'm trying to be so chill right now, but I think they're trying to get all our money, and I'm sorry.
You're startling Miss Clucky.
I'm sorry. You know, you and her are supposed to split the entirety of our fortune.
That's so true. I'm already splitting 50-50 with Miss Clucky, okay? I don't want to split it even further, okay?
All we're saying is we think we could be really helpful to you and your business, make you even more money than you already have, okay?
Yeah, like, over the few months that we've been here, we've noticed so many inefficiencies. We can streamline everything. You guys don't have to do anything.
You think you know a better way to stomp the grapes?
Do we send them money and they send us back more money? Because that's apparently that's how it works in our world.
I mean, that's.
You cut us checks, and then, yeah, we make more money for your business.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much it.
That's right.
That checks out.
That does check out. Okay, Miss Clucky.
Can I still claim her as a dependent?
I'm going to get the estate, okay? You get the cars.
I can't talk to this chicken anymore.
Better be careful.
That's a crazy
chicken. She's flapping. She's so excited.
Look, I'm sorry to freak out at you guys. I'm already pretty on edge because Miss Clucky keeps trying to get my aunt to rip me out of the well already, so I'm kind of like, I don't really have any other skills, you know?
It's no problem.
You're just a little on edge. So you're saying is you want a promotion? Is that what you're saying? You want to be like the bosses and then get paid more and then...
And we'll run this business.
We'll run it.
And do I just get to keep doing the grape stomping and the egg stomping?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
You should keep doing what you're doing. Just leave the rest to us.
Okay.
Sound good?
I don't know, AMA.
I am very used to doing very little work around here, so that does sound great.
Okay,
AMA. Seems okay to me, right?
Okay.
Where's your guys' first move going to be?
There, you do have a lot of produce that you guys just keep in the warehouse that we need to move quickly before it expires.
What?
Those are my snacks!
Uncle Jeff's snacks.
He's a hungry boy.
You don't eat them at a fast enough rate.
Oh. Can I have some still?
100%. We'll have Jeb's corner.
Jeb's corner.
Okay. And I still get 10% of the grapes to stop?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this seems good to me then.
I know a super jacked girl that can move all this stuff for us.
Banana phone. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong.